Welcome everyone with the fifth part in our personal protective equipment safety series, the hearing protection devices. If this is your first time with our channel, kindly subscribe, like, comment, and share the video. Firstly, we need to know what is the factors determine the excessive noise. Certain operations generate noise requiring hearing protection. Employee exposure to excessive noise depends upon a number of factors, including the noise level, as measured in decibels, the duration of each employee's exposure to the noise, whether employees move between work areas with different noise levels, whether noise is generated from one or multiple sources. Generally, the louder the noise, the shorter the exposure time before hearing protection is required. For instance, employees may be exposed to a noise level of 90 dB for 8 hours per day, unless they experience a standard threshold shift, before hearing protection is required. On the other hand, if the noise level reaches 115 dB, hearing protection is required if the anticipated exposure exceeds 15 minutes. What is the noise reduction rating, or NRR, for the hearing protectors? The effectiveness of hearing protectors based on the device's noise reduction rating, NRR. Manufacturers of hearing protection devices must display the device's NRR on the product packaging. For example, the earmuff at the photo illustrated that the noise reduction rating is 23 decibels. It means that if you expose to 100 decibels and you wear this earmuff correctly, the exposed noise will be 73 decibels only. If employees are exposed to occupational noise at or above 85 dB averaged over an 8-hour period, the employer is required to institute a hearing conservation program that includes regular testing of employees' hearing by qualified professionals. Types of hearing protection devices. There are three main types of the hearing protection devices. The first type is the single-use earplugs. This made of waxed cotton, foam, silicone rubber or fiberglass wool. They are self-forming and, when properly inserted, they work as well as most mold earplugs. The second type is preformed or mold earplugs. These are individually fitted by a professional and can be disposable or reusable. Reusable plugs should be cleaned after each use. The third type is the earmuffs. The earmuffs require a perfect seal around the ear. Glasses, facial hair, long hair, or facial movements such as chewing may reduce the protective value of earmuffs. Hearing protection personal protective safety signs. Here there are some examples of safety signs related to the hearing protection and noise like. Warning signs, risk of high noise levels. Mandatory signs, ear protection must be worn. Safe condition signs, ear protectors available on request. Information signs, high noise area, wear a hearing protection. You can drop your feedback or comments in one of these platforms. We have a complete 2 hours free safety course on OSHA noise safety in our channel. This online training will increase your knowledge about noise protection. The course link is shown above. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, press like, subscribe our channel, comment, and activate the bell to receive news and updates.